On the show today, Olympic gymnast Simone Biles visits Liberty University, and she shares about the Rio Games and about her faith.
And the emotional story of two sisters who play in the LU lacrosse team and how they've leaned on each other and God through unbelievable loss. That's all ahead. Game On starts right now.
What's up? Welcome to Game On. We're excited and honored that you made time for us today. Alongside of Rhett McGibbon, I'm Matt Warner.
Yeah, we have so much to talk about on today's show that we didn't really leave time for a welcome. So with that, let's get right into it.
I like that. I like your decisiveness, Rhett. Business. Let's get right down to it. And by the way, business is booming for the Liberty basketball team. After claiming their sixth straight road win on Saturday, the Flames return home on Tuesday to face the Blue Hose of Presbyterian. Rhett actually owns a pair of Blue Hose. That's another story for another day. The Flames would have a little trouble putting the old ball in the basket initially, but their defense would keep them in it. Liberty forced 26 turnovers on the night. That tied a season high, and eventually the offense would start to click. A big reason for that, the play of Mayo Baxter Bell. Three names, one great player. Retro freshman had a career-high 19 points, including some highlight reel plays to lead the way. And speaking of highlights, perhaps the best of the night, courtesy of another freshman, Brock Gardner, finishing the alley-oop late in this one. As the Flames pull away in the second half, they win it 71-51, and with the win, move to 9-2 in Big South play, while remaining in first place in the conference standings.
The Lady Flames basketball team closed out their first half of Big South Conference action with an impressive win over Campbell. Nene Johnson would score a team-high 13 points, while P.N. Green put up 12 points as the Flames took the game 58-52. With the win, Liberty now is in sole possession of third place in the conference and just one game behind co-leaders Campbell and Radford. Well, some big news coming out of women's soccer. Athletic director Ian McCaw has announced Lang Wiedermeyer as the new head coach of the program. Wiedermeyer joins Liberty following a fantastic 17-year run as the head coach at South Dakota State. During his time with the Jackrabbits, Wiedermeyer led them to four Summit League championships, along with four trips to the NCAA tournament. He's a local boy growing up in Roanoke, Virginia. He began his collegiate career at Virginia Tech. Well, sticking with Liberty Athletics, Brittany and Victoria Tickle are separated by only 2 years of age, but they are essentially connected at the hip. The Tickle sisters are key components on the lacrosse field for the Liberty Flames. Growing up, they had each other's back on the playing field, and as you're about to see, they have each other's back in life.
The first sport that we played together was basketball, right?
And then, yeah, my sophomore year, your senior year, that was the first year we played lacrosse together.
Sports like brought out a lot. Like, we're just very competitive with each other, but it's like healthy, you know? Mm-hmm. We've always been really close. Like, I've always had her back and she's always had mine. So anyone ever messed with her, they knew they had to come through me, so.
Our family, we were the typical Christian family, but we were so into sports. So it was God and sports and like, literally, like, after we go to church on Sundays.
We always rode bikes together, like, around town. We were always that family that's like, oh, yeah, they ride their bikes together with the dog. It's just, like, the typical family, and we would always just go work out. And my dad would, like, he would always be like, all right, you think it's just going to be a bike ride, but we'd bike to, like, a high school. And, all right, it's good, we're going to do bleachers now. And it's like, really? Like, can't we just bike?
Yeah. Our dad definitely pushed us.
My mom, she was more of the one who like took us to the events. You know what I mean? Like she was like the cheerleader. Every weekend we would travel, she would be there like encouraging me on the side and like always giving me pep talks.
Our mom was the like typical old fashioned like walker.
And she had her fanny pack. So when she'd walk, she'd have like her like cassette with her radio and it would go like, and it's like the headphones, like this, she had her headphones, so she'd be walking. And I'm like, me and Brittany would be like, Mom, like, okay, how much longer do we have?
Like at one point I had a rollerblade beside her because I couldn't keep up.
I was like, my parents are both like very outdoors. So like my mom loved being outside. So I think that's like why we love being outside. The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. When we found out that my mom had depression, it was she tried to commit suicide, so that's how we knew things were bad. But there was never a time where we saw things getting worse. It kind of just happened like that. And none of us knew. Like, none of us knew what she was going through. And when she tried to commit suicide the first time, we both, that's how we knew, like, something was wrong with her. When I got home, you could just feel it in the house, like something was wrong. And I like walked upstairs and I like saw this like look in my dad's face. I mean, she had tried to commit suicide before, but like the look in his face looked like the life was just taken out of my dad. Well, at first I didn't even know. I was like, what did she do? Like, what happened? And he was like, you know, she drove to a bridge and she jumped off the bridge. And I don't know, it felt like my life was just like, my heart was just like ripped out of me. It was hard.
I think at first we kind of took it both in different ways.
She was always something that was there for us to talk to, and when she passed, it was like really hard for me and Brittany because that was taken away.
Our grandma probably was
saved us.
She was. She like took the mom role, and I really like, if we didn't have her, like we wouldn't be here where we were today. We were so blessed to have God put her in our lives and have her take the time out of her own day and come live with us and stay with us and take care of us.
And I think my dad, like, he was like our rock. Like, he was something like, I mean, yeah, I never once saw him like let it affect him. Like, he didn't let, even though I knew it was, he didn't, like, he made sure that me and Brittany were okay, like every day. You know how you have like your heroes? Like, my mom was one of them, but like, so was my dad. Like, my dad was my hero that got me through it too. My mom's favorite Bible verse was Psalms 23. And that's just something that she always like lived by. And so we both ended up wanting to have a piece of like something that my mom always lived by to look at and be like, even through your darkest times, like God's still with you. And that's just something that we live by. I got it on my shoulder for lacrosse. So like when I look at it, like, and I have my penny on, like I know that she's there. It's something to look at and remember her by. I just know she'd be proud of us because, I mean, just how far we've come together and how close we've gotten. I mean, we've always been close as sisters, but like, I know she's just like fist pumping. Like, this is awesome. Like, my daughters are playing at a Division I level, and like, just to see how far we've come, like, I know she'd be proud. You know, my mom left and my mom's gone, but we can minister to those people who are going through similar experiences. Some people come up to me all the time, they're like, I don't even know how you do it. Like, that's what they say to me. And I really don't know how we do it.
It definitely brought us so much closer to God. Like, I think I can say for both of us, like, we have a much stronger relationship with him than I would have ever had. You know, he really does have a plan. Like, he, like, there are things that he will put in your lives. Even though he takes someone out that's so important, he puts so many other people that are so important in our lives now, and it's just awesome to see.
It is.
Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Just a moving story. We, of course, thank Mike O'Neill for producing that piece. Impressive young ladies, their willingness to share their story, yeah, for sure. to open up, and to do so knowing that their story could impact someone else and change someone else's life. And certainly we appreciate them opening up to us.
Yeah, I'm sure the Tickle family, anybody out there that's struggling with any thoughts or feelings of depression, they'd want you to talk to somebody. It doesn't show weakness talking about it. It shows a ton of strength.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Well, thanks to Mike O'Neill once again for that piece. Well, we turn now our attention to baseball. Yeah, baseball, hard to believe, but the season almost here. And this past week, the Big South Conference put out their annual preseason poll. Now, despite receiving two first-place votes, Liberty finds themselves picked to finish third in the conference behind High Point and Campbell. The Flames bring back 14 seniors on this year's squad. And with new head coach Scott Jackson, the pieces are in place for an exciting season. Now, it all begins February 17th with the first home game being played on the 22nd. Well, time after time, we've shown you examples of great athletic facilities here at Liberty University. And this past Saturday, they officially opened another one. A grand opening ceremony was held for the brand new 169,000 square foot indoor track complex. It immediately becomes one of the best track facilities in the country. Now, the ceremony coincided with the third annual Darius Dixon Memorial Invitational, which saw a number of Flames perform well. But the real story on this day was the celebration surrounding the opening of this world-class facility.
I sometimes wonder if the alarm's going to go off and I'll wake up, or if I actually already died and I'm in track heaven. I don't know which it is, but I'm beginning to realize it's reality. So we're excited about it. We're excited about the future. Our athletes are excited. Recruits, when they come in this building, they just drop their jaws. And so I don't know what the Lord has for us in the future, but it certainly looks good from this point of view.
Great to see Coach pumped up. Well, if you're used to the frozen confines of the LaHaye Ice Center, got a makeover this past weekend as the Liberty Wrestling team hosted the NCAA National Duels Tournament. Unique atmosphere created plenty of excitement for Flames fans and the athletes themselves. The Flames would ride that energy boost into the finals where they would compete against a very tough Emmanuel team out of Georgia. Unfortunately, the Flames would fall in the finals, but the coaching staff was very happy with their young team's effort that's comprised mainly of freshmen and sophomores. Well, coming up, we hear from one of the biggest stars from the Rio Olympics, gymnast Simone Biles.
Plus, from Africa to Lynchburg, Julius Nwosu shares his story about how basketball has taken him around the world. That's all when Game On returns.
Josiah Barty.
Here.
William Byron. Is William here?
Hi, I'm William Byron, driver of the number 9 Liberty University truck for Kyle Busch Motorsports. Racing in the Camping World Truck Series doesn't leave a lot of extra time in my schedule, but I didn't want to put the brakes on my education. That's why, when I'm not on Liberty's campus, I continue my studies through their online program. While in the shop with Kyle and the team, I'm able to maintain a busy race schedule and continue pursuing my degree. Keep your education on track. Check out Liberty University online and on campus.
We'd like you to meet a few people. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and Debbie. Matthew and Mark enjoy some of the best on-campus housing options and the number one ranked dining hall in the country. Luke eats on the go. And Debbie has a really comfy couch and makes some of the best lasagna you've ever tasted. Matthew and Mark love watching their team compete at the Division I level. Luke gets a lot of exercise, while Debbie works out her green thumb. Matthew and Mark are educated by some of the country's best professors. Luke and Debbie attend one of the highest-ranked, most affordable universities of its kind. And whether at their kitchen table or in another country, they're educated by the same great professors as Matthew and Mark at Liberty University. With over 500 online and on-campus programs of study, there's no one way to be a student. So, what are you waiting for? Connect today at liberty.edu. Liberty University, right now.
Where are we going? What are we pursuing? Success? Greatness? Or something bigger? We believe in a calling that reaches beyond ourselves, where leadership is shaped by service, and knowledge isn't just an individual pursuit, it's something we're meant to share. Where strength isn't demonstrated in power, but through humility. Answer the call at Liberty University.
Liberty University.
This is no ordinary school.
This is more than an education.
We're here to equip students.
To make an impact.
On a global scale.
We believe we were created.
To make a difference.
To serve God.
And each other.
Wherever we are.
Whatever we study.
We are.
Champions for Christ.
We are.
We are.
We are Liberty University.
Welcome back to the show. You know, here at Liberty University, we have an event that takes place three times a week called Convocation. The entire student body gets together to hear from some of the best pastors, musicians, entertainers, and athletes. And this past week, Liberty had the honor of featuring Olympic gymnast Simone Biles. The four-time gold medalist at the Rio Games spoke at length about that experience, but she also spoke about her faith. Biles shared about how prayer, and specifically prayer with her teammates, helped her get through what was, at times, a tense experience at the Olympics.
It was pretty nerve-wracking, and you try to not think that it's the Olympics, but every event right there before you walk up, there are Olympic rings everywhere, and you're just like, gosh, stop looking, stop looking. We would all sit there and pray together, so we find that special for us. So I think it's special for me, even going out into the competition, I'd be praying in my head, praying for my health on each event, that I could stay focused and not get too distracted because it was the Olympics.
Like, call them sleepers, you know, those recruits that don't jump off the page at you, but in the blink of an eye have turned into a stud? Well, that was the case for the Flames and Julius Nwosu. This sleeper would awaken during his time at Liberty and quickly became one of the program's all-time greats.
Ah, the Vine Center. It's hosted a number of great players during its life, one of the first being a young man named Julius Nwosu. Julius would go on to have a great career, playing with the likes of David Robinson, Dennis Rodman, but his is a story that might never have happened. You see, Julius is from a small rural village in Nigeria, and you might be surprised to know that basketball wasn't even his first sport.
Volleyball was first. I played volleyball with my brother. You know, we were all boys, you know, so we all played volleyball. Between volleyball, I was playing soccer as well, you know, because when I go to school, it's soccer. Everybody plays soccer. So there's a guy, his name, we call him Engine Knocker, you know, so he's like real strong, I don't know. They made him out of a steel or something. So he grabs me one day, say, if I ever see you play volleyball or any other sports, I'm gonna kill you. He grabs me and pulled me over to basketball. That was it. I think I was about 14 or 15. I played basketball since then.
Julius's path to Liberty basketball came thanks to a traveling missionary who approached Julius at a crusade.
And he was like, do you play basketball? I said, yeah. He didn't really quite believe me, but he was like, really? I was like, yeah. He was like, can you spin the ball in your finger? I was like, yeah. He said, I'm from Lutherite Seminary. You know, my school doesn't have basketball, but I used to be at Liberty University and they have a good program. I would like you to go there. And then he went back, took my pictures, gave it to Coach Myers and everybody. They looked at it like, okay, let me try it.
The coaching staff was taking a chance. Many players from similar backgrounds simply don't work out, but there was something in young Julius that gave them hope. His adjustment to a new culture, however, would not be easy.
It took me a while. It took me like about a month or two to actually understand what people are saying. Not that I didn't speak English, you know, because Nigeria, we speak English. I'll go to class, I don't understand anything. So I take a tape recorder, go to class and record everything, come back and listen it over again, and then I get it. Yeah, it happened for like 2 months. And then I remember after 2 months, I walked into the Moss Hall and a guy was talking. It looked like my ears were open. I'm like, I can understand everything he's saying.
But the language wasn't the only adjustment he would need to make. American basketball was a little bit different than the style he was used to playing, and he would be forced to sit out his first year at LU. But that's when a classmate would invite him to play in a city league. Who knew that games in a small local gym would end up changing the trajectory of his career?
So every evening he picks me up, and I'll go there and I'll play. All that I keep improving, just like picking up the game, quick, quick, quick. When it comes to being athletic, I was like top of the line, top of the chain, you know. I could flat out run, do anything. I play soccer, play volleyball, so I think that's what helped me, because I can make a mistake and catch up. First day of practice, I was just right there with everybody. You know, but at first I was, you know, like every day I worried. Like I said, I go to that small chapel, I pray all the time. I was like, God, man, they're gonna kick me out. I'm not even good enough, you know. I don't think, you know, they say I'm so good, you know, they hype everything up, but I don't think I can measure up to what they're telling me, you know. But I was glad, like, I had that year off. I used that year and work. Because every day I get out of class, I come to the gym, play, shoot, do whatever.
He did more than just hold his own during his career at Liberty. Julius would be a two-time All-Conference player, finished with over 1,200 points, and even have his jersey retired. And that was just the start of his career.
When I graduated, I went to Spain. I tried out with Dallas. I tried out with Dallas and Detroit, Lakers. They all have interest to get me back to the training camp. But my agent, you know, preferred me going to Europe, playing in a good league, and then come back the next year and try it again, you know, which worked. I'm feeling like, okay, I'm good now. So the Spurs invited me to a mini camp. I came down, man, I put it on the guys. They were like, man, that kid can play. And then after the mini camp, everybody was supposed to break and go home. They didn't let me go. They were like, stay. And then they brought in Terry Cummins, J.R. Reed, played one-on-one with me, did the same thing again. They're like, man, we got a kid, he's a keeper.
Julius played the 94-95 season with the Spurs before going back overseas. All told, he played in 14 different countries. These days, he's living in Houston, Texas, retired from basketball, but not from sports entirely. He's now in a regional soccer league playing with teammates from his home country of Nigeria.
I was glad to be a member on the team. And I've two seasons I played, I led the team in high school scoring, the league, not even the team, the league. So, fun playing. Yeah, we won the championship 5 times in a row, 5 straight. Yeah, everybody panicking. Oh, maybe you guys should go find a different league because they're so much better than everybody.
Julius's career may have begun on this court, but it's the lessons he took with him when he left that truly make him a champion and make him one of the greatest to ever don the Liberty uniform.
Thanks to Mike O'Neill for producing that piece and that incredibly good-looking host there, whoever that guy was. Fantastic work by him. Time now for Warm, Hot, and Fuego, the segment that launched Rhett McGibbon from little-known Canadian broadcaster to worldwide stardom.
Yes, this I still, my original fans, thank you.
Top three players in Liberty Athletics over the past week. Rhett, Warm is where we begin. Who you got?
Warm, Nene Johnson. What did I say a couple weeks ago about women's basketball? There'd be a time when Coach Green would look down the bench, need a veteran to come up big, and this former JUCO star did that. She scored 13 points against Campbell, had just a great night, and, you know, Campbell, a good team this
year. Absolutely, really good
defense.
Co-leader
in the conference. Yeah, I think the actually first defense scoring team in the nation, and then Liberty came out in the fourth quarter.
I don't care.
He's like, yeah, whatever. He's like, I'm gonna get you. He got him, that's for sure. They had a great game. 13 points for her, helped propel her team to victory.
And again, you're seeing a different player on different night stepping up for them.
Yeah, it seems like every single night there's a new young lady stepping up, taking charge.
Absolutely. All right, moving on now from warm to hot.
Hot Pacheco, this guy.
Georgie. Just,
I love this kid. He's a freshman. We were talking about this. It's something as small as just changing your shoes.
That's right. He struggled. Just,
yep, exactly.
Changed
he was struggling.
His kicks and look at him now.
Yeah, he's just rolling. He's just a defensive. He's really good defensively. Yeah. He's great offensively. This guy has the knack of just kind of driving to lane. He distributes very well, but then sometimes he'll make that initial like, oh, I'm going. Defenseman backs off, defender backs off, and he just drains a three right in your face. This guy has just so much confidence and poise for a freshman at this level. It's scary to think, like, this is his first year, and he's only like midway through his first year. Think about in 2 years from now, how good is this guy gonna be? Coach McKay just must be smiling. Even though he makes fun of me all the time, I'm happy for you, Coach.
The crazy thing about George is he doesn't turn it over.
No.
You're a freshman, you expect there to be some mistakes, some turnovers. Not with that kid. You love a point guard that doesn't turn the basketball over.
100%.
And finally, it all builds up to this, Rhett. En Fuego. Who is En Fuego this week? I can't wait to see.
Back to men's basketball, the big man, Mayo Baxter Bell. This guy, just what a game he had. He must be a Taylor Swift fan, because let me show you right here. The steal. He goes down the lane. He's going to go through the legs here, and then he's going to shake it off. Then he just takes to the rack.
Yeah,
a great night for him.
Yeah.
19 points. You know, he started off really rough. Like, he was, it felt like he couldn't get one to drop.
Yeah.
And then That shot actually right there, got it to fall, and then from there on out, it was fantastic. Doing a great job of using his size and his body against perhaps some taller guys, but a little bit leaner. He'd get the gap, nice little soft touch around the rim. He was just on fire, and then he highlighted it by that two-handed slam. He was just on fire that night. I was pumped up for him. A great kid, and good to see him
Reminds
do well.
Reminds me of a young Rhett McGibbon on the basketball court.
I don't know about that.
But well, I'll ask him about the Taylor Swift stuff.
I never could jump.
We'll see about the Taylor Swift fandom. We'll ask him about that. Rhett, great job as always. Still to come, the top five plays from the month of January. The best of the best when we come back.
So you've chosen Liberty University. What's next? Well, you could study here. Or here.
Or way out here.
You could build this, catch that, or play this. Sure, you'll have early mornings, long days, and some longer nights. But that's how we grow. No matter who you are, where you live, or what you want to do, your education starts here.
Hey, welcome back to the show. Well, it's time for one of our favorite segments, and I hope one of yours, the game on top five plays of the month.
Yeah, we're taking a look back at the best plays from January, which I don't know if you realize this, Matt, really makes them the best plays of 2017.
You always think a little bit deeper than anyone else for that. Nicely done. We begin with play number five. Liberty Hoops taking on Campbell back on January 7th. Check out this, the behind the back feed from John Dawson to Lavelle Cabell. Buries the three. When you're on the receiving end, Brett, on a sweet pass like that, you darn well better knock it down.
Oh, yeah.
Give him the assist on that. But here comes my favorite part of this highlight. Are you ready for this? Lavelle going back down. Who's lurking? Who's creeping in the background? Brett McGibbon, the never blinking eye. Always lurking. I like it, Brett.
The never blinking eye. We stay at the same end of the court for women's hoops. The Lady Flames facing High Point and Ola Makarot beating the first quarter buzzer. The Polish princess
with a deep three. She is from Poland. That's why he said that. Absolutely. Play number three. This past week, the Flames were on the road at Longwood. Check out Ryan Kimwright taking it in the lower stomach, ending up on the ground, still burying the three. He's done that like eight times this year. So good, and you know McCracken loves it.
Yee!
There you go.
Absolutely fantastic. Let's stay at the same game. Here it goes. This guy, this young buck. Look at him get up there. Just absolutely fantastic. Brock Gardner. I think we're going to see a lot more of that in the future, Matt.
Oh, you think
so? I really do. I just have this gut feeling that Brock Gardner is probably going to throw it down again in the not too distant future.
It's almost as if you know what play number one is.
I may.
It's almost as if. Here it is. Play number one, top play from the month of January. Guess what? It's Brock Gardner again. The last day of the month.
Oh,
Brock.
Look at that
down.
Scream. Hear me roar.
Are you quoting? You quoted Taylor Swift and Katy Perry tonight? Is that what's going on?
I don't know what's going on.
We're off the rails. Yeah. Brock Gardner, look at the elevation. Young fella getting on up. Yeah, he'll throw down one or two of those before he's done. The freshman, so talented.
I was lurking yet again right there. And
I didn't think
he was going to get it.
But I believe it.
He nabbed it.
Nicely done. All right, that about does it for us this week. As always, hit us up on the website and on social media at GameOnLU. He's Rhett McGibbon. I'm Matt Warner. Thank you so much for tuning in. We'll see you right back here next week.
At Liberty Online Academy, we believe in providing a flexible, convenient, accredited, and affordable education for your K-12 student. So if you're looking for an alternative for your child's education, check out luonlineacademy.com today.